Dear Ms. Nieto Hilarte, I hope I pronounce well. Dear Begonia, dear Mr. Flores Lorenzo, dear colleagues from the managing authorities, dear representative of the farmer unions, Copa Cogica, colleagues from the European Investment Bank, European Investment Fund, ladies and gentlemen, I'm really glad to be here today in this very nice place and to open together with my colleague, the Director General from the Spanish Ministry of Agriculture, Food and Environment, this first FI Compass, EFRD FI Compass conference on using financial instruments in rural development. I also want to take this opportunity to pass on to you the very warm support and message from my Commissioner Phil Hogan, the European Commissioner for Agriculture and Rural Development, who is very strongly supporting the efforts and is very supportive of the idea, and he would like to see more and more offering different way of investment for the agriculture and the rural economy in the EU. I want to thank you all for making the effort to come here today to participate to the public, to the debate on financial instruments. And I hope that you will be very active and we will have a very rich discussion today. I want to thank the European Investment Bank, the FI Compass team, and my colleagues in DG Agri that organized this event. And I am also extremely pleased to see that in the audience we have a very large and diverse range of participation. So starting from experts in the managing authorities, the paying agencies, we have the bank and financial institutions, representatives, European Investment Bank and European Investment Fund. We have investors, farmer unions, we have researchers, advisors. So a very wide, and sorry if I forgot to mention all the kind of stakeholders, but we have around the table stakeholders representing the rural economy at large and not only the farming community. So it is almost 1 year these days since we organized the first FI Compass conference. This happened in 22nd, 23rd of June last year in Ireland, in Dublin. And since then, a lot has happened. And first of all, from the rural development point of view, I think that we managed to have all the programs, rural development programs, approved in the EU, and they are now up and running. But I think you all agree with me that this year was a very difficult year, especially for farmers and the ones in the dairy and pork sector. They've been hardly hit by the crisis on the market. And I have to tell you that quite often in Brussels, and not only in Brussels and everywhere, we discuss what kind of instrument we can use in the public policy to help these farmers. And it is our task to act in a way supporting all EU farmers and food producers who still want to invest and compete within Europe and globally. And financial instruments are one of efficient options in doing this rightly. So we are here in Spain, and I'm very happy that a lot of stakeholders and farmer representatives, together with the ministry, together with the representative of the regions, they come here to discuss about this opportunity. I know how important is Spanish agriculture for the EU. So I know that Spain is the largest producer and exporters of the olive oils. And if my figures are right, I think 44% of the global production is produced in Spain. I know that Spain is the second largest producer of fruits in the EU with over 80 different products. It is the world's third largest wine producer, and if my recollection is good, I think it is the leader in area occupied by vineyards in the world. And it's also the second largest pork producer behind Germany, with a census of more than 26 million of animals. And Spain ranks fifth in the EU export with agri-food products and more than 9.3 billion euro in 2014 was exporting from the agri-food sector. So you see how important is Spain, agriculture in Spain for the EU. And in terms of EFRD and support provided by the Common Agricultural Policy, Spain has an envelope of about 9.45 billion EFRD to support the rural development. And this is programmed in 19 programs. So 17 are regional programs, one is a national program, and there is also a framework program. This represents a significant investment source for businesses and people. But it's not enough to cover all the needs, as you all know. And this is why a mix of financial instruments, which may attract additional private capital and can unlock unleashed potential hidden on all these farms that cannot get access to funding, I would say at the favorable conditions, or startup and young farmer who do not have credit history and cannot even qualify for banks funding, it may become a huge driver of economic growth and prosperity. And I think that the importance of this sector in Spain and I think the recovery from the financial crisis, the sector can and play an important role. Let me say a few words about the role of financial instruments in the rural development policy, in the EU rural development policy. So, as it has been mentioned already, rural area is in great need of investment, and all kind of investment. So investment in farms for modernization, structural adjustments, in infrastructure, in new business models, in modern processing technology. And this is why we see financial instruments as a vital element for our policy model. Of course, we are used to work a lot with grants, and most of our programs, they are based on grants. But we consider that it's our role and our obligation to offer to our beneficiaries a wider range of tools and instruments that can better put them in the possibility of addressing the challenges and the opportunities they have to develop their businesses. So now that the financial and economic crisis is behind of us, we need to find new and well-designed way for policy delivering. And we must open the investment horizon in front of our stakeholders. So financial instruments have a role to play in all our priorities, and in particular to boost agricultural competitiveness, production of and energy efficiency, social and territorial development. It comes without saying that investment in a variety of form will be required to create a modern, dynamic agri-food sector we believe can still play a central role in the EU in creating jobs, maintaining the quality of personnel, and boosting growth in the coming years. Ladies and gentlemen, agriculture and agri-food sector remain the largest employer in the EU economy. So overall, the agri-food sectors offer jobs for about 44 million people. If to this we add also the forestry, this figure goes even higher. And if we want to maintain the role of this sector in employment, in growth, in promoting innovation and development, we need to offer the tools necessary to invest, to adapt to the challenges and equip them well to deliver. Well, we come often to the discussion why we need financial instruments if we have grants. And I have to tell you that in rural development policy at the EU level, we have an European Agricultural Fund for Rural Development, which has a fixed amount of about 99.6 billion euro. And in the programmed amount, we also have an obligation of the member states to co-finance, and the overall public financing in the rural development policy in general amount to 161 billion euro. Of course, there is also possibility to attract additional private funds. But if we look to the fact that following the financial and economic crisis, the investment, public and private investment, has shrunk, and we aim, at least the Commission aim, to come back to the level and then exceed the level of before the crisis in investment, we need to be creative, and we need to develop a more innovative way of delivery. So, therefore, we try to promote financial instruments, and we are working hard on this. What are the advantages of financial instruments? So, first of all, financial instruments can attract additional private capital. Second, the financial instruments can has a leverage effect, and sometimes we talk about a factor of 5 in some of the financial instruments we develop. There is another aspect which is very important, is the reusing of the resources. So once the resources are used, they are coming back, and they can be used again and again. We can reach a much bigger number of beneficiaries. And not least, I think, at the end of the day, so the public money put in by the European budget, they will stay with the member states, and they can use it again, and they become the ownership of the member states, and they can be reused for the same purpose, for the same policy. And another advantage is that we are challenging this money and this support through a financial intermediary, which are better placed than the administration, the managing authorities, in assessing valuable projects, in assessing the risk, and in selecting the best projects. So financial instruments need to be tailored to farmer needs. We are long advocating for this. Cash flow fluctuations and price volatility have their impact on the market and needs to be considered in the design of financial instrument. We think that the existing models and EFRD rules create sufficient flexibility to allow member state and region to do exactly that. So you would agree with me that EFRD and the rural development programs, it is one of the most, the biggest investment sources for rural economy and agriculture. And let me elaborate on some of the enormous possibility for investment in our policy in the period 2014-2020. Now that we have all the programs approved, and we have 118 programs at the EU level, we have seen that we have 75 billion euro total public support targeted towards investment, of which almost half, something like 34 billion euro, are to be spent on agriculture and agri-food industry. And through this investment, member states aim at supporting 340,000 farmers in modernizing and restructuring their farms, and more than 150,000 young farmers to start up their businesses. With a small fraction of our budget, of less than 3%, we expect to support 58,000 rural entrepreneurs setting up businesses, and this will result, if they are successful, in about 70,000 of new jobs created in the short to the medium run. Our EFRD supports also leader interventions and leader projects, and of course investment. Leader is also support investment in rural economy. And the leader, the allocation for leader is just 6 billion euro for this period, and it's expected to deliver another 42,000 jobs, many, if not most, in rural area, where new sources of employment is rather scarce. But that's not all. We have, for example, almost 12 billion euro placed in investment domain that have never been explored with the help of financial instruments, such as rural infrastructure, or were partially or sporadically supported, such as forestry. So what have we done so far to help and promote the financial instruments? So first of all, in terms of the legal framework, we have improved considerably our legislation at the EU level, clear the new rules, align implementation detail with the European Structural Investment Fund policy, whilst keeping the specificity of agriculture. When we are now offering excellent legal conditions for those member states willing to use financial instruments. We also provide some financial incentives in the legislation. So for financial instruments, we top up the co-financing by the EU contribution. For the financial instruments developed under shared management, and we can offer 100% coverage by the EAFRD for the financial instruments set up at the EU level. Well, we also created on-the-shelf instruments, which member states they can directly take them and apply directly. So the advantage is that we have tried to clear as much as possible the state aid aspects, so that we don't need to go again and again through the state aid. At the same time, and now because we are talking more and more about simplification and reducing complexity, we try to make the conditions for the financial instrument more acceptable. We have recently amended our implementing regulation to require less in terms of programming, an element that has to be put into the program. And we also remove one of the blockages in terms of modifying the programs, allowing member states to add a modification, special modification for financial instruments if they want to program financial instruments. Then we have brought in expertise because you will agree with me that this is a quite a specialized field, and especially the financial intermediaries, the banking sector, they have more knowledge than the public administrations in developing financial instruments. Therefore, we have worked a lot with our colleagues from the European Investment Bank, European Investment Fund, to create, to bring in their expertise and to help the member states, the managing authorities, in delivering, in assessing the situation, in programming the instruments, and then introducing them into the program. So we have signed a memorandum of understanding in 2014 with the EIB, where we wanted EIB to provide this expertise to us. We also wanted that the EIB take in today's strategy, the development strategy, more and more the agriculture and rural economy. And we also hope that they are going to put more resources for the sector in their lending activities. And we have developed a lot of capacity, and we want to put this capacity at your disposal. And we try to work on some specific instruments. So we developed a guarantee scheme, which is now tested in one of the regions in France. We're working on a risk-sharing loan fund, which is going to be tested in another member state in Romania. And we consider that the two other instruments will be developed in the forestry and in the research, development, innovation. Knowing the need of the member states to be supported in this assessment and in this work, we have organized a targeted coach, and this has already been taken by a number of managing authorities in several member states, and we know that there are requests for further coaching for other member states. So we have put all these instruments at your disposal. We are organizing a lot of awareness raising and a lot of communication activities like this one. We organized last year three FI Compass conferences in Dublin, in Vienna, in Riga. We count organizing more this year. We started in Madrid. We do another one in Rome in two weeks. Then we go to London in the autumn, and then we count organizing a big event in November in Brussels, the big FI Compass conference in Brussels. So We know that work is ongoing. In order to introduce a financial instrument in a rural development program, you need to do an ex-ante evaluation. And I would like to congratulate those managing authorities that have already done this ex-ante assessment or are in the process of doing it. Some of them, they finalized the process, and now they are in a process of assessing and taking this into consideration for further programming. Some of them, they are still in the process. Some of the managing authority would like to enter into this process. So I just want to reiterate our full support and our engagement that if you want to program financial instruments, we are treating this as a top priority. So if a managing authority put forward a modification of the program to introduce a financial instrument, I can assure you and all my system in Brussels, my colleagues, up to the Commissioner Phil Hogan, will treat this as a top priority. You know that the Commission has fixed as an objective of doubling the use of financial instruments. And let's be honest, doubling the use of financial instruments, it's not such an ambitious target, because if we compare the total amount of financial instruments this is compared with the previous period, 2007-2013, that's not such an ambitious. I mean, we have 410 million euros of investment through financial instrument. And if we compare this with the 74 billion public expenditure for investment through grants, that's less than 1%. So I think that we would like to be a little bit more ambitious, and I call on you to explore this possibility. And I think that you should not see the use of the financial instrument as a competition or a threat for grants. And I would like to pass very clearly this message to you. I think, first of all, financial instruments can help you to first better implement the rural development programs, because it can help speed up and absorb the grants and the investment you are providing through grants by providing or helping to get the match funds and the private contribution. You can consider using these instruments either in combination with grants or separately. But this will be an additional opportunity offered to our beneficiary for developing investments and investing and supporting the creation of jobs and determining economic growth. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are standing in front of a great opportunity. So let's take the momentum for this conference and use it to full effect in the coming weeks and months. We need the experts from all sectors represented here today to make ownership of this process and design and implement well-performing, properly targeted, efficiently managed, and transparently implemented financial instruments. This system will provide critical added value by attracting additional private capital to benefit forward-thinking farmers, agribusinesses, and rural entrepreneurs. So let's resolve to make this financial instrument play a crucial role in the CAP up to 2020, and also in its post-2020 development. Let us build on foundation for the intelligent agriculture of the future using the financial building blocks available to us in the present. And let us collaborate intensely in the short term while bearing in mind the long term. So you know that we are starting now the reflection for post 2020, and you may have heard already that we are organizing in September Cork 2 conference, because this year we celebrate 20 years from the Declaration of Cork that put the basis of a standalone pillar in the Common Agriculture Policy, which is the rural development. So I think we need to be well equipped looking for future and to provide to our beneficiary, to our rural economy, all the instruments that can unlock the potential and take the advantage of all the opportunities we have on the market. At the EU level, there are a lot of interesting projects going on, and we are talking about the circular economy, about the bioeconomy, and a lot of opportunities, renewable energy. Well, we're working on a digital single market, on the energy union. And I think that our sector can play an important role. So I am quite confident that today we'll have very rich discussions about using the financial instruments for supporting investment in the rural economy. I would like to thank you all for making the effort to come here, and I hope that you will actively participate in the debate. Thank you very much for your attention.